everyone, it's me, Carmela, from Happy Calories Don't Count. And in today's video, I would like to muse a little bit on this spiritual principle about how your perceptions influence or create your reality. And it is a personal example from my own life. And as many of you already know, part of my story includes the eating disorder from hell. At 17, I was hospitalized for anorexia at 80 pounds. By 25, I'd been in treatment 4 more times, and at 30, I was 200 pounds and suicidal. And this whole happy calories don't count thing is what I've learned on my journey of healing and transformation, and how it specifically relates to you and how it can help you if you suffer from body image or weight issues or are recovering from an eating disorder. I hate labels because you can have pain and shame and drama around your body and your weight and be all stressed out about food and exercise and never be identified as someone as having any kind of disorder. And you can also be someone like me who I just feel like a lot of my life I've been wearing the scarlet letter, and I just keep trying to move past these labels so that people can hear what I have to say. And the fact that I had an eating disorder has nothing at all to do with the content. So it's still going to be applicable to you even if you haven't had an eating disorder. So anyway, I pretty much missed my senior year of high school. I was in the hospital, as I'd mentioned. I think I maybe went to school maybe 12 weeks because I was hospitalized twice. I was there for September. I was hospitalized in October. I got out right before Christmas, and then January term started, and I was back in at the beginning of March and didn't get out almost till the end of May when, you know, I'm fighting with everybody saying, you know, if you do not let me out, I am not going to graduate. You need a certain number of school days to be able to graduate. I need to graduate. So I really don't remember my high school experience very much. But my perception of it, you know, is I felt really isolated and alone. I felt kind of like a wallflower, which is ironic because I was a cheerleader. So I don't know, it's crazy, it doesn't make sense or whatever. But I knew that everyone at school knew that I was in the hospital because, hello, cheerleaders are out there at the football games and suddenly there are 7 instead of 8. And so, you know, I knew my absence would be noted if for no other reason than the pep rallies and all of this stuff. There was an odd number of cheerleaders and we had to change all of our routines. So what's going on, right? Well, during that time, I got a lot of letters and cards from everybody at school. And I remember being really angry and offended by these letters and these cards, just saying, you know, they don't really care. It's just, you know, it's just the popular thing to do. Someone's gonna go around and say, oh, let's sign a card for Carmela and have everybody in class sign the card, or, you know, whatever it is. We're just gonna show everybody that we love our support. And that all of the little notes were so banal. They were just, you know, like, we miss your smile, get well soon, come back, you know, all of that stuff. And I just remember just that these letters and these notes were evidence that they didn't really care, you know, and all of this stuff. Well, we recently had some storm damage to our house and there was a little bit of a flood. So I started cleaning out old boxes. And in some of these old boxes I found were these letters and these cards from when I was in the hospital. And you know, I'm a lot older and hopefully a little wiser now. And I went back and I'm reading through of them from a completely different perspective. You know, granted, I'm a different person now, but reading them, I can give them so much grace. You know, they were 17 years old. You know, what does a 17-year-old know about how to really communicate how they're feeling about someone? Plus, you got to remember, this was in the 80s when, you know, people didn't really know what eating disorders were. They were just starting to come into the spotlight with Karen Carpenter and Cherry Boone O'Neill. I mean, before that, people didn't even know what it was. And it wasn't mainstream. It wasn't pop culture. I was actually in one of the first pilot programs for an eating disorder program here in Seattle. And so my friends, they're like watching someone they know waste away and not really understanding what it is and not really knowing what to say about what it is. So like they didn't really have the skills or the tools to be able to communicate any kind of concern or love or support or anything like that. And then here I am, you know, in my own little drama with all of that. So it was really interesting for me to go back and read some of those letters, and especially, you know, yes, a lot of them still were the very pedestrian, oh, we miss your smile, you know, come back and get well soon and all of that. But a lot of them were some heartfelt notes, you know, that again, they might not have had the language or the writing style to be able to communicate their support and their love and their concern. But as an older, wiser person, I can see that in there. And so in this whole musing about perception versus reality, you know, I felt very alone. And when I came back between my two stints in the hospital, you know, I felt like I had this big scarlet letter on me, and you know, everyone knew, and suddenly everyone was watching everything that I ate and everything that I, you know, cheer practice or whatever, and everybody's judging me and everybody's watching me, and you know, that made me crazy. And a lot of my life has been formed and informed from this. You know, I've gone on to, you know, conquer battles and slay dragons and fight demons and all of this stuff and come out of that so that, hey, I can create happy calories for all of you guys. And believe me, I wouldn't have it any other way. You know, I'm very happy where I am today. But, you know, there was this part of me that was wondering, you know, what would life had been like had I been able to see the love when I was 17? You know, had I really been able to see that I did have friends and see that people did care about me. And believe it or not, there were a couple of boys that actually had crushes on me. I mean, come on, this was a girl that didn't have a date in high school. So it's to be able to see that and experience that, that would have transformed my experience of high school. And I probably still would have had an eating disorder, I don't know, you know, but this whole idea of how that shapes your life. And so perceptions influence reality on a very practical level. And you can even see it today in the world of politics and social justice and the Twitter mobs and whatever, that how you perceive something is going to influence your reality of how you experience it. So my rambling will conclude with this little message to you that says, you know, if you are feeling pain, if you are feeling angst, or if, you know, whatever it is, you know, give yourself some grace and take a breath and cry it out or walk it out, run it out, whatever you need to do. And then when you get the emotion out of your body, so you're not quite feeling so bad, take a moment and just experiment and play with the idea, what if? You know, what if you're looking at this in a way that isn't necessarily helpful? What if there's another way to view this situation? What if the love is real? Could you be open to the love that is surrounding you? And if you could, how would your life transform? So I know this was a little bit of a ramble and it was a little personal and all that good stuff, but of course, Happy Calories is built out of my own pain and drama. So healing my own stuff can only help serve you. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I always appreciate a subscribe and comments, and I will see you next time. Take care, bye.